Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in our biology session we are discussing our lesson, that is reproduction in animals, and in the lesson already we have discussed some points. Now we will move for the next point from the same lesson, that today we will discuss about young ones to adults. Okay, so how the young ones get produced and how that young ones get transfer into or get transformed into an adult, that all the things we are going to see deeply. So if you recall, in your 7th standard already you have discussed about the life cycle of the silkworm. Okay, so is that the young silkworm and the adult silk moth looks the same? No, obviously you will give answer what? No, because the young ones look totally different from the adult one. Okay, so as the new individual born through the eggs or by hatching of the eggs, then they started to grow and then slowly they converted into an adult one. But in this case or in this situation, in this period, what happened? There are the certain newborn are there. There are the certain newborns or there are the new individuals are there. That individuals look totally different from an adult. Okay, generally if you see that, then if you take about the puppy, then that puppy almost the copy of the dog. Okay, or if you take the kitten, then that kitten almost looks same similar to the cat. And if you take the human baby, then that human baby also looks similar to the human being. But in some case, in some situation, there are the certain organisms are there, those whose newborn or their new individuals are totally different from an adult, and to get converted into an adult, that newborns are or that new individuals are going to different phases. And while going from the different phases, there are certain changes happens in their body, and at the end they get converted into an adult one. Okay, so let's see what is mean by that. The transformation of the larva into the adult through drastic change is called metamorphosis. Okay, so just now I said that there are the certain individuals are there, newborn individuals are there, those who looks different from their adult. Okay, and that process is only called as what? Metamorphosis. And what is the definition of the metamorphosis? The transformation of the larva into the adult. Okay, so the transformation of the larva into the adult, but from the larva to the adult, while going through this phase, there are the so many big changes happens in them, and that process is called as what? Metamorphosis. So if we talk about the metamorphosis, then there are the certain organisms, those who are showing the metamorphosis, we can say that what? Frog is there, also mosquito is there, silkworm is there. These are the certain organisms, those who are showing the metamorphosis. So among all these, we will discuss about the one example of the metamorphosis. We will go through the metamorphosis in frog. Okay, so as we know, the frogs are laying the egg, the female frog. Okay, the female frogs are laying the eggs. So as we know that the female frog is laying the number of the eggs in water only. Okay, so the female frogs laying the large number of the eggs in a water. From that eggs, after the certain period of the time, the babies or that newborn individuals which are present in the egg, they get hatches the eggs, and the small larvas from the eggs comes out, and that small larva is called as what? Tadpole. Okay, so that tadpole started to grow, and while growing, after the certain period of the time, that tadpole started to bear the legs. Okay, that started to appear the legs in their body. As the tadpole started to grow, and as the both the pair of the limbs get produced in the body, then that tadpole started to grow into the young frog. After the development of the both the pairs of the limbs, then the young frog started to crawl on the ground. Okay, after that the frog continuously started to grow until it reaches to the adult frog. Okay, so until it reaches to the adult frog. So here what we have discussed, that tadpole. Okay, so the tadpole is doesn't look similar to the adult frog. Okay, you can see that what here is the tadpole, but if you go through that, the tadpole is started to grow While growing, the tadpole started to appear the both the pair of the limbs, and also the tadpole is having the tail. When the tadpole get grows into the, or when the development is happens in the tadpole, it get comes in the young stage. In the young stage, the tail get detached from the body and it started to continues the development up till it reaches to the adult frog. Okay, so in this way, what happened? The initial or the newborn is a different than the adult one. Okay, so the newborn looks totally different from the adult one or the adult stage, and that process is only called as what? Metamorphosis. Okay, so see here, tadpole looks so different from the adults. Okay, the tadpole of the frogs looks so much different from the adult frog. Also, we can say there's some example of the caterpillar or the pupa of the silkworm looks very different from the adult moth. Okay, so the caterpillar, or we can say that the pupa of a silkworm looks totally different from the adult moth, and that process is only called as what? Metamorphosis. So what is mean by the metamorphosis? The transformation of the larva into the adult through drastic change is called metamorphosis. So for the metamorphosis, we can take the one more example, that is mosquito. In the case of the mosquito also, the female mosquitoes are laying the eggs. From that eggs, the larva hatches out, and then after within the 2 weeks, that larva get converted into the adult mosquito. So this is about what? Metamorphosis, that we can say that what? Young ones to adult. So dear students, up till now we have discussed about the sexual mode of reproduction. But how do you ever think there are the certain other organisms, we can say about what? There are the certain microscopic organisms are there. So how are they showing the reproduction? Which type of the reproduction or which type of the mode of reproduction they are following? Okay. So now it is the time to discuss on this thing. So now in this next point, we are going to discuss about there are the certain other organisms, or there are the certain microscopic organisms are there, and that organisms are also showing the reproduction. And that mode of the reproduction is called as what? Asexual reproduction. Okay, so as we know, we have discussed about in the beginning of the lesson what is mean by the sexual reproduction. When there are the necessity of the two parents, okay, then it is called as what? Sexual reproduction. In the sexual reproduction, there is a need of the two parents. Without two parents, the sexual reproduction will not happen. But in asexual mode of the reproduction, only one parent is enough for the production of the new one individual. Okay, or the production of the new one individual is takes place with the help of only one parent. Okay, so there are the different several methods of the asexual reproduction. For example, we can say that what? Binary fission, budding, fragmentation is there, and regeneration. So these are the certain methods of the asexual mode of reproduction. Among these methods, we are going to discuss about the binary fission and about the budding. So let's discuss about the first one method in the asexual mode of the reproduction, that is nothing but what? Binary fission. So this binary fission is shown by the, or is performed by a microscopic organism, and the example of that microscopic or the name of that organism is nothing but what? Amoeba. Okay, so as we know, the amoeba is a single cell organism, or we can say that what? Unicellular organism, which are showing the reproduction method, that is what? Binary fission. So let's discuss about how they are exactly showing a binary fission. This binary fission is shown by the fully grown amoeba. What happens in that? When the amoeba grow mature, or when the amoeba cell get mature, then what happened? The nucleus which is present in the cell started to get divides into two parts. Okay, started to get divides into two parts, and the process in which what happened? There is a division of nucleus, and that process is called as what? Karyokinesis. Okay, that process is called as what? Karyokinesis. What is meant by the karyokinesis? The dividation of the, or the cell started to divide the nucleus. The nucleus started to get divides in the amoeba, and that process is called as what? Karyokinesis. And once this process is get finished, after some period, after that what happens? Once the nucleus get divide, after that the cytoplasm is also started to get separate. Okay, the cytoplasm is also started to get divides along with the two nucleus, and that process is called as what? Cytokinesis. So, okay, that process is called as what? Cytokinesis. So see here, cytoplasm divides into two parts around each nucleus, which is called as what? Cytokinesis. Okay, so fully grown amoeba showing the binary fission. What happens in that? The nucleus started to get divide, and that process of the dividation of the nucleus is called as what? Karyokinesis. After the dividation of the nucleus, the cytoplasm is also started to get separate or started to get divides, and that method or that process is called as what? Cytokinesis. Then after that, once the cytoplasm is get divides, then this amoeba get detached from the place and then started to form the two different cells or two new cells, which we are calling as what? Daughter cell. So here what we have seen, from the single amoeba we are getting the two daughter cells. Okay, so what we can say that from the single parent there are the production of the two individuals. Okay, and after the production of these daughter cells, these daughter cells also started to grow, and when they were also get fully grow up, then they are also showing the binary fission. Okay, so this is all about what? Binary fission in amoeba. So what we can say that what? Reproduction in which an animal reproduce by dividing into two individuals called binary fission. It means what? From the single parent, we are getting the two daughter cells, we are getting the two individuals, and that process is called as what? Binary fission. Fission means what? To get split. And binary means what? To get splits into two parts. It is called as what? Binary fission. Okay, so this is the first method of the asexual reproduction. Now we will discuss about the next method of the asexual reproduction, that is nothing but what? Budding.
Student, now we will discuss for the next method of the asexual reproduction, that is nothing but what? Budding. So what is meant by the budding? So the budding is a type of the asexual reproduction, in that what happens? The buds get appears on the parent's body, it gets started to grow, and after the proper growth or after the proper development, it gets detached from the parent's body and started to live as a new individual, and that process is called as one budding. This budding is mainly shown by the hydra, a sea anemone, claw. Also we can say that for chelicerans. Okay, so all these organisms are being reproduced with the help of this budding method. So let's discuss how exactly budding is happens in the hydra. Bulges are the developing new individuals called buds. Okay, so once the hydra get mature, okay, they started to produce the bulges on the body. Okay, so see here we can say that this is the parent hydra. This parent hydra started to produce the bulges on the body, and that bulges is called as what? Bud. That bulges is called as what? Bud. So this bud started to grow gradually. Once it get appears the mouth and the tentacles, then they get separated from the parent hydra and starting to grow as a separate individual. Okay, so this is the method of the budding which happens in the hydra. Okay, so let's see what happens exactly. This is the parent hydra, or we can say this is the mature hydra, starting to produce the bulges on its body, and that bulges is called as what? Bud. This bud starting to grow gradually, and once this bud appears the mouth and the tentacles. Here you can see this hair like structure. The hair like structure is called as what? Tentacles. So after the proper development of the mouth and the tentacle, this new hydra starting to get separate from the parent hydra and starting to live as a separate individual. Okay? And that type of the mode of the new reproduction, that what happened? Only the one parent is involved. That reproduction is called as what? Asexual reproduction. Okay, so see here, reproduction in which only a single parent is involved is called asexual reproduction. So the hydra is also showing the mode of asexual reproduction, which is called as what? Budding. While the amoeba is also showing the asexual mode of reproduction, which is called as what? Binary fission. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the young ones to adult. Also we have discussed about the asexual mode of reproduction. In that we have discussed about the binary fission, and also we have discussed about the buddy. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. It is the time.